Thanks for joining us tonight. Dignity. That's a word state lawmakers have heard a lot this year, whether they're talking about justice, housing, health care, or a person's right to choose. And today, dignity came into sharper focus in conversations about the rights of Minnesotans facing some of their toughest times. And that's in the form of two bills. The first would give cancer patients the opportunity to look the same no matter how much money they have when the disease robbed them of their hair. And the second is about letting terminally ill people take control of when they die. John Croman heard stories about all of this at the People's House today.
Senator Kari Dziedzic opened a window into her own personal health crisis when she asked her colleagues to think about what it's like to go through chemo. In fact, she said that people who've been through that should not have to go online to shop for cheap wigs.
We took amendments from authors.
When Senator Kari Dziedzic returned to the Capitol last spring after her first battle with cancer, she was wearing a synthetic wig that cost her $500 out of pocket. It was actually her second $500 hairpiece because the first one was ruined when she opened her sister's oven on Mother's Day.
I had the resources to buy the wigs, but not everybody does. This bill will allow others to get wigs to help them present their best self to the world.
Dziedzic is now fighting a cancer relapse at home, zoomed into the Senate Commerce Committee to pitch her bill requiring insurance coverage for wigs for those who've lost their hair due to chemo.
I know insurance companies don't like mandates, but this isn't locking in an ineffective treatment. It's putting patients first.
Senator Dziedzic's bill would require a doctor's order and would cap the wig coverage at $1,000.
The psychological impacts range from loss of self-esteem, social anxiety, depression, and it is a time burden trying to figure out how to conceal your hair loss. When my hair fell out, it was like a cold slap in the face. It was, okay, now you look like a cancer patient.
The committee also heard from the American Cancer Society's Minnesota lobbyist, Emily Myatt.
For our perspective, this is a great bill that's going to take a piece of that financial toxicity, a piece of that stress off of cancer patients and their families' plates so they can very much focus on their treatment and their survivorship plan.
Dignity at the end of life is the point of another bill moving through the legislature. We're talking about the Medical Aid in Dying bill, which went to the Public Safety Committee.
But for 16 excruciating days, his personhood slowly eroded because he had no options in death.
Dr. Ellen Kennedy spoke in favor of Representative Mike Freiberg's Medical Aid in Dying bill. The House Public Safety Committee also heard from opponents, including Attorney Greg Decker.
This medication could be used on vulnerable people, and we all know that autopsies are almost unheard of in cases involving the elderly or those with chronic illnesses.
Republicans branded the bill as state-sanctioned suicide.
Objectively, a choice is good if it furthers life. This does not.
Most of the people who use medical aid in dying are dying from certain types of cancer or from ALS.
It's suicide, no matter how you look at it, folks.
I think there is a clear distinction between somebody who uses medical aid in dying and somebody who dies by suicide.
What's the difference?
People who use medical aid in dying are already dying.
The bill passed the Public Safety Committee on a straight party line vote, with 8 Democrats voting yes and 6 Republicans voting no. A companion bill is also moving through the Senate. At the Capitol, John Croman, Care 11 News.